Hello everyone and welcome back to CLGTart channel. Let's continue with Clip Studio Pen tutorial series for basic. And today we will talk about reference in Clip Studio Pen, and I'm using macOS anyway. When you open Clip Studio Pen, you'll go to the menu here, Clip Studio Pen, and choose preference, or simply go to the use the hotkey, that's it, command with key or control with K, that's it. And then a box will appear, that is the preference box. With the preference box here, you can use that to change some setting of the things like tool, tablet, texture, interface, everything in Clip Studio Pen, and make it custom in your way. So you can see that the interface in here does have the dark color, right? And maybe you're asking why you don't have it. You can change it by simply click to the interface in here. In the box color, choose the dark color or the light color, depending on your choice. You can change the adjust intensity here by make it darker or lighter with this one. For the light color, it's the same. You want to gray or white, depend your choice. I prefer the darker anyway. And here, the IME control. That's it, when you take this one, which it will automatically activate the input method editor when editing text layer. That means those two will be affect to when you write something, like you when creating a comic and you add text, this one will affect for your choice. And I just figure out when I use, you can see that I'm from Vietnamese and I use the special keyboard to write some word in Vietnamese. So that's why I have to change the input methods in here to VNI. And when I turn this one on, every time I click this one, it will automatically change back into the English keyboard. So when I want to make sure that not happen anymore, I will turn off this one. So if you are from the country that you're not using the keyboard ABC alphabet keyboard or anything else, you make sure to check this one to turn off the automatically after the input method in the basic way. Okay, that's it. And after you finish it, remember to click OK to make it effect. The next thing that I want you to pay attention, that is the cursor tab. You click to there and a set of cursor will appear in here that you can change the shape of your cursor when you are drawing or writing. It maybe can change to the triangle or a brush side or brush side with a cross. I prefer the brush side with the cross more. So I will show you what the difference here and what with none. Click OK in here. You can see that I'm using the pen and I choose it for triangle. So that's why here, that's why it appeared like this one. And if I choose the brush, you can see that it has the cross in the middle. If there's something that you need to like really careful, and you must do it exactly what it's doing, like you're drawing the line like this one and you want to continue exactly where that point, the crossing here is very, very useful. And for the eraser, that I choose none, so you can't see anything appear in the screen, and you just know it is there when I start to erase some line here. So pay attention with your preference here and choose the one that fit you with your choice. And I prefer the brush side with the cross more. That's it. Next one, that is the canvas. Those settings will help you to creating automatically and just one time edit, that is enough. So here when the canvas, you want to view how the display quality will appear as a default of high quality. And here in the transparency box, you can change the color of this one. If you want a transparent look in blue, not boring like gray color, you can change it too. Because in transparency box, we have two square color, right? One is white and one is gray. You can change it into the pink if you want. Next, for the file, that's really, really important that we need to enable canvas recovery. That you will set the time that cell recovery data every minutes. You will set the time in minutes, and the lowest is 5 minutes and the highest is 16 minutes, depend your choice, okay? And those things is really important when you start to using the Clip Studio Pen, because you will modify all the things in here that help you easier to use the program. And in case you want to know more about this one, you also have the manual guide from Clip Studio Pen to read it. And here I will provide you a special link, that's clipstudio.com/GEN user guide here, and you will have the home page is Clip Studio Pen instruction manual with a lot of things around here, or you can go into shirt for preference because there are lots of things in this program, and you can learn about something that CLGTart and export and tone palette anything in here. So that's it all about this tutorial, actually about the introducing video, and I hope this video is not really boring. In the next one is not talking about the basic thing like this anymore, creating some effect for you guys with Clip Studio Pen, and you also can use that in Medibank Pen Pro too. So look forward to this new video, and after that I will go back to the basic guide here. I know that there's someone still confused a lot like me at the beginning. So that's all. Thank you for watching and see you in the next one.